Every day, we wash our hands, clothes, and dishes. We take showers and flush the toilet. But how often do we stop to think about what happens next? Where does that water go? Hi, my name is Melissa. Welcome to the virtual tour of Fairfax County's Noman M. Cole Jr. Pollution Control Plant. During this tour, we will show how our wastewater treatment plant helps make your dirty water or sewer water clean by removing pollutants before our reclaimed water is returned to the local waterways. Before we begin the tour, let me tell you a little about Fairfax County's Noman Cole Treatment Plant. Fairfax County's wastewater management program maintains over 3,300 miles of gravity sewer pipes and 63 wastewater pump stations located throughout the county. These pipes and pump stations move wastewater from your homes and businesses to one of the region's 5 advanced wastewater treatment plants. Noman Cole is an advanced treatment plant with a capacity to receive 67 million gallons of wastewater per day. This is enough to fill 90 Olympic-sized swimming pools. On average, we receive and treat about 40 million gallons of wastewater per day from nearly 265,000 residential, commercial, and industrial customers located in the southern part of Fairfax County. Our wastewater management system and team of dedicated professionals work 7 days a week, 24 hours a day, and 365 days a year, a task critical to providing reliable sewer service to the residents of Fairfax County and protecting water quality, human health, and the environment. First, a quick safety check before we head to the plant. Hard hat, safety vest, long pants, sturdy shoes. Looks like we're ready. Let's go.
Welcome to our first treatment process. Behind me are the bar screens. This is where untreated wastewater arrives at the treatment plant. Here, wastewater passes through bar screens that collect and remove trash, large objects, and debris that could damage equipment in the treatment plant. This includes items that are improperly disposed of down toilets and sinks and do not disintegrate or dissolve in wastewater. Once collected, the trash and debris are mechanically raked onto a conveyor system, dewatered, and collected in a dumpster that's sent to the landfill. After passing through the bar screens, the wastewater continues to our primary clarifiers, which are large settling tanks where heavier items settle to the bottom as sludge, and lighter items such as fats, oils, and grease float to the top as scum. Once settled, an automated belt skims the scum and sludge from the tank, sends it through solids processing where it is then treated in the on-site furnace. These are the first processes for treating wastewater. Both processes use an enclosed environment and have an associated odor control system. This is a very important part of the process for us and the surrounding community.
These processes also remove fats, oils, and grease and wipes, even those labeled as flushable. These can clog and damage wastewater systems. This results in sanitary sewer emergencies, like backups into homes and overflows into the environment. You can help by disposing of these items in the trash.
The wastewater now enters our secondary treatment. This is a biological process where we use microorganisms that are so small they cannot be seen with the naked eye. The ASTs are a biological nutrient removal system. They remove a significant amount of nitrogen as well as phosphorus and organic matter. In these tanks, wastewater moves between two zones: the aerobic zone where oxygen is added and the anoxic zone where no free oxygen is added. This is what makes the tanks look different at one end versus the other end. After multiple passes through these zones, the microorganisms have been so effective in removing waste, which they use as food, that we need to add supplemental carbon to the system as another food source to keep them alive. After the ASTs, wastewater continues to the secondary clarifiers, another settling process. But this time we are removing solids and microorganisms. Some of these cellular microorganisms are returned to the ASTs to start the process again. In some places, wastewater treatment ends after secondary treatment. This was true for Noman Cole when it went online in 1970 and only had the capacity to treat 18 million gallons of wastewater a day. But if treatment may end here, then the water should start to look cleaner, right? Look at the muddy water entering the clarifiers, and then how clearer the water looks going over the weirs into the next step of the treatment. Those microorganisms do a great job.
we can see the critical role microorganisms play in treating wastewater. Improper disposal of household hazardous waste down the drain can potentially harm the microorganism population and the quality of our final effluent. So, if it's toxic, corrosive, ignitable, reactive, safely pack these items in a box, take them to the household hazardous waste facility for proper disposal. After secondary treatment, wastewater is sent to retention ponds before starting our advanced treatment process.
Why do we use retention ponds at this point? Well, the final two treatment processes operate most efficiently when a constant flow is maintained. From the retention ponds, wastewater is pumped to the moving bed biofilm reactor, where we start advanced treatment. This biological process uses small plastic media in the shape of pasta wheels, microorganisms, and supplemental carbon to further lower nitrate and nitrite levels and ultimately produce a higher quality final effluent. The plastic media increase the surface area for microorganisms to live and form small colonies referred to as biofilm. The supplemental carbon is their food source. From the moving bed biofilm reactor, wastewater enters the tertiary clarifiers where the chemical ferric chloride is added to remove pollutants in a process called chemical flocculation. Ferric chloride naturally attracts phosphorus, microorganisms, and other solids which form flock. They become heavier and settle to the bottom of the tank. The settled sludge is sent back to the head of the plant to start the treatment process again, and the treated wastewater continues to our final treatment process.
Final treatment includes filtration and disinfection to remove particulate and microorganisms. As wastewater flows into the filtration system, suspended solids and microorganisms are removed. It passes through a disinfection process to eliminate microorganisms prior to discharging our final effluent into Pohee Creek. Disinfection can be obtained through a chlorination-dechlorination process or ultraviolet light. Since beginning operations in 1970, Normanco used chlorine for this process. In early 2021, we are converting our disinfection process to ultraviolet light. This process improvement instantly neutralizes any remaining microorganisms with ultraviolet light and significantly reduces the chemicals used.
This completes the treatment process. It takes about 24 hours from the time wastewater enters the plant until the time it is discharged. So, how do we know that our final effluent is safe for aquatic life in Pohee Creek? We have an on-site, accredited, state-of-the-art environmental monitoring laboratory that analyzes samples from all stages of the treatment process to ensure each plant process is running efficiently and that our final effluent meets regulatory requirements. Also, our plant operators, warehouse staff, mechanics, instrumentation technicians, electricians, maintenance crews, environmental technologists, and administrative personnel work together as a team, leading us to decades of success within the Wastewater Management Department.
Fairfax County Wastewater Management is committed to protecting, restoring, and enhancing the environment and ensuring there is fresh, accessible water for generations to come. Fairfax County, with assistance from GMU, has been monitoring water quality and aquatic life in Gunston Cove for 35 years. Throughout this study, GMU and Fairfax County have documented significant improvements to water quality and the aquatic ecosystems of the cove. The Water Reuse Project uses reclaimed water for irrigation and industrial purposes. This helps save drinking water and reduces pollutants such as nitrogen and phosphorus from entering our rivers and streams. Flood walls have been incorporated to keep surrounding creek water out, prevent flooding, and protect the treatment process. Since 2012, the plant has participated in the PJM Emergency Response Program that provides relief to the electrical grid and helps curtail energy use during emergency events. This resulted in the installation of new generators capable of powering all wastewater treatment operations. Norman Cole continuously looks for ways to improve processes, reduce our carbon footprint, and show environmental stewardship. Norman Cole has received the Platinum Peak Performance Award for 22 years of continuous permit compliance, maintained certification as an E4 participant in the Virginia Environmental Excellence Program, and is recognized with the Utility of the Future Award. You can also help protect the environment. Remember to throw trash in the trash can. Keep fats, oils, and grease and household hazardous waste out of your drains, and only flush human waste and toilet paper.
Thank you for watching our virtual tour. For more information, visit our website.